five major principles directly I received from Parashakti Mahamayi, Paramashiva, directly. So listen, universe is conscious. Universe is conscious. This is the most important, greatest truth. Understand? All of us, you, me, everyone, all of us are here with a conscious purpose, conscious reason. We are not accident. Understand? One of the worst thing done to human beings is we are made to believe we are accident and we have a petty existence. Our existence is silly. No. Listen. You are conscious. I am conscious. Universe is conscious. You have a reason to feel connected to me. I have a reason to come and sit every day with you. We both have a reasons to exist together. Our relationship is extremely sweet, strong, powerful, romantic, loving, intimate, passionate, conscious relationship. Understand? It's absolutely conscious. All the other words I said, passionate, intimate, romantic, loving, caring, integrated, all that are small, small, small words. Because I don't have any other words, I put all those words. Conscious is the real. Understand? You are consciousness. I am consciousness. Universe is consciousness. And all we do is not lost. See, the energetic, active, alive contribution you do to the world, knowingly, decisively, is never lost. Good or bad? Listen. Listen very clearly. Now I am coming to the principles. Universe is consciousness. You are conscious. I am conscious. We all exist. Very decisively, consciously, not accidentally. So whatever we contribute, good or bad, does not die. So now, I'm going to give you principles, one or two truths. See, in low level, animal level of existence, all the good you do, you have to enjoy. All the bad you do, you have to suffer. Then next, human level, if you raise, you can exchange, means cancel all the bad for the good you did. If you raise to the God level, divine level, the good and bad does not bring direct result to you because you are not doing it for yourself, but it brings the collective effect. Listen, I'll tell you now. I'll give you the example. In animal level, if you give food for five people, you will get that punya. You have to enjoy that punya. You cannot avoid it. If you hurt five people, you have to go through that pain. You cannot avoid it. Neither good nor bad can be avoided. You have to go through both. For the good you did, you have to spend time in Swarga. For the bad you did, you have to spend time in Naraka. Mandatory. In human level, if you raise little bit, I'll tell you how to raise. If you raise little bit, you can cancel with each other. For example, oh, this person did this much of bad. 5 people have been hurt by him. Okay, let him do good for 5 people. With that, it is neutralized. For example, if he has deprived food for 5 people, okay, give food, do annadanam for 5 people. It's neutralized. Prayaschitta is enough. You are free from the punishment. You don't have to suffer the karma just by prayaschitta. It's a human level. Next, divine level. Neither he gets the punya of good, nor he gets the sin of the bad, because he himself is not doing it for his personal gain. In the divine level, he does what is good for the world, what is good for the larger society. He makes only that kind of decision. So the result also goes to society. He himself does not suffer. Like decisions of Krishna, he never suffered the outcomes of good or bad from his decisions, because he took decisions always for the good of the larger number of people. So he never personally had any suffering. Same way, Rama, all his decisions, he decided for the larger good, never for personal gain. So never he suffered the results, outcomes. Understand? In divine level, because of your unselfishness, your actions and reactions, good or bad, does not bring any result for you. It goes to the society for whom you decide.